always remember, when we need number of positive roots, how many roots it will have? Maximum of 6 roots, including all. That may be real, may be complex roots. Whatever it is, there will be maximum of 6 roots will be there. So, number of positive roots are to be taken like this. You have to write the signs. Plus, minus, minus. You have to see the change of sign in this. The number of changes of sign in this one. What is it? This is 1. Again, that is plus to minus. 1 change, minus to plus. Second change, plus to minus. Third change. And minus to minus only. There is no change. Minus is minus. Next is minus. So how many changes are there? 3 changes are there. Therefore, maximum of positive roots will be 3. Don't forget, not exact roots. Not exact positive roots. Maximum of positive roots will be 3. Then, of course, for that one, maximum of 3 will be there. You can understand that. But we will see, we'll discuss the negative roots also. How to write the negative roots? You have to take it as fx and take f of minus x. What should be f of minus x? Minus x power 6. No, it is plus x power 6, plus 2x power 4, plus x cubed, plus 5x squared, plus 2x, minus 2. Do you understand what I'm saying here? What I did, x replaced with minus x here. Then write the number of changes here. Plus, 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 minus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many changes of sign are there? Only 1 is there. So you'll have maximum number of negative roots. Maximum number of negative roots is equal to 1. Maximum number of positive roots is 3. What does it mean? If the positive roots are 3 and maximum number of negative roots are 1, then let us suppose they have maximum number. Maximum number 3 plus 1 is 4. 3 plus 1 is 4. What is the degree here? 6. In 6, we have got that there are 4 maximum number of roots. 4 maximum number of roots. Then how many roots are remaining? 6 minus 4. It is 2. It is 2. What should be those 2? What should be those 2? We say that you will have least number of complex roots. The other 2 will be complex roots. So you will have least number of complex roots as 2. And if it is maximum, then the least number of complex roots will be 2, because power 6 is there and here you have got only 3 plus 1, 4. Remaining 2 must be the complex roots. So the maximum number of complex roots will be, in this case, 2. Least number of complex roots will be 2, and the maximum number of positive roots will be 3, and maximum number of negative roots is 1. Like that. So you have to find out that, you have to write the change of sign. Change of sign is to be written. Okay. Next one, please. Go through that. Next question. In the next question, you can understand, if Q, R are positive numbers, what does it mean? Q, R are positive numbers means it's always greater than 0 and they are given to be positive numbers, and I can take them as QR belongs to N, otherwise positive numbers, N. Then the number of negative roots of X cube plus QX plus R equal to 0. X cube plus QX plus R equal to 0. You need number of negative roots. Understand that? To find out the number of negative roots in this case, you have to make use of the differentiation concept here. You have to make use of the differentiation concept here. What is the power of X here? 3. So how many roots it will have? It will have 3 roots. That is, those 3 may be complex or real, whatever it is. But complex will be obviously 2 only. Complex roots always occur as even numbers. Why should it be? If one is a plus ib, another will be a minus ib. When the coefficients are real, you will not have only a plus ib as root. Definitely, if a plus ib is a root, a minus ib will also be there. So, conjugate that is complex roots will always be occurring in even number. Even number. Then if even number they occur, one of the roots must be real otherwise. But all the roots will not be complex for this one. Why? You will not have three complex roots. You will not have three complex roots. So let us do this now. Let me take this as fx. Understand. What should be f dash x? 3x squared plus q. What is 3x squared? Positive. X squared positive, 3 positive, positive. Q is always positive. It is given to be positive, and hence it is always greater than 0. Understand? That means when the first derivative is greater than 0, you all know very well that it is always an increasing function. It is always an increasing function. It is a monotonically increasing function. In such a case, what should it happen? What should it happen? What we have to do here to draw the graph? If it is a monotonically increasing function, whether the graph is like this or whether the graph is like this, we don't know. We don't know. Keeping 0 like this, if the graph is like this, it is also increasing. And if the graph, maybe it may be taking negative root like this, or it may be like this also. Where it intersects, we don't know. Where it intersects, that means whether it intersects positive x-axis or negative x-axis, we don't know that. That is to be decided somehow. That is to be decided somehow. So, for that purpose, what we do now, we will find out f of 0. That means at 0, I'm checking it whether it is positive or negative. Then if I write 0 here in place of this, f of 0 is nothing but r. R is nothing but greater than 0. Why is it greater than 0? It is given to be a natural number, or it's a positive number. So it is greater than 0. So now I can comfortably mark this. It is 0. And at 0, it is positive. That means it must come above x-axis. This is to be positive, it must be above x-axis only. If it is negative, then this goes down. If it goes down, the graph will be like this. Because it's continuously increasing function. Greater than 0 means what? Monotonically increasing. Continuously increasing function. Continuously increasing function, or strictly increasing function, we can say. It will be like this if f of 0 is negative. But f of 0 is not negative, it is positive here. That is why the graph will not be like this. The graph will be like this. You have to choose some point here. Then in such a case, to get it continuously increasing, it must go like this. Because it is given to be continuously increasing. Then, what is the question there? Please go through that. If q are positive numbers, then the number of negative roots of x cube plus qx plus r equals 0. Number of negative roots we need. Number of negative roots means, it is, root means it intersects x-axis. Root of this function is here. It is equal to 0. So it is lying on negative x-axis, please. It is lying on negative x-axis. Then you tell me whether this root is negative root or positive root. It's negative root. How many negative roots will be there? Only one negative root will be there. That's what you must understand there. So what is the option there? You'll have one negative root. This much of concept is involved in this one. When the equation is given, find out the derivative. And from the derivative, you understand it is greater than 0. From that one, we understand that it is monotonically increasing function. Monotonically increasing function. But we don't know how it increases, whether it increases like this or whether it increases like this, we don't know. To decide whether the graph will be like this or like this, if it is like this, this f of 0 must be negative. So that is why I'm finding f of 0, but f of 0 I have got it to be positive. That is why f of 0 lies above x-axis, and hence this is one of the points, and because it is continuously increasing, the graph goes like this, not like this. So it intersects only in one point, so it intersects no negative x-axis, so only one negative root for this one. So the option is one negative root. Let's go to the next one. If q, r are positive numbers like this only, then the number of complex roots of x cube plus qx plus r equal to 0. The same question. The same question. Complex roots we need. Complex roots we need means how many real roots are there? Whether it's negative or positive. Whether it is negative or positive. Is it a real root or not? It is a real root. It is a real root. How many real roots are there for this one now? What is the power of x here? 3. So how many roots will be there? 3 roots will be there. Among them, one is real. Only one is real. The remaining two must be complex. Because according to the graph also you can see, it is nowhere intersecting x-axis. It intersects x-axis only in one point. That means only one real root. Remaining all will be complex roots only. So how many complex roots will be there? 2 complex roots will be there. So the option is 2 complex roots. Next one, if the roots of ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus d equal to 0 or in HP, then the roots of dx cubed minus cx squared plus bx minus a equal to 0 or in what? Which progression they are in? That is to be decided. Let us see that. What is the equation given there? Ax cubed plus bx squared plus cx plus d is the equation given there, which is nothing but fx. Which is nothing but fx given. And what is the next equation given is dx cube minus cx square plus bx minus a equal to 0. So there is a change of sign and the coefficients are also reversed. Coefficients also reverse. It is possible only through, because minus is there, it is possible only by replacing x with minus 1 by x. Replacing x with minus 1 by x. So if you replace x with minus 1 by x, it will be minus a upon x cube. It will be b upon x square. It is minus c upon x plus d. So if you take LCM here, is equal to 0. This is also equal to 0 because it's an equation. If you take LCM here, dx cube minus cx square plus bx minus a equal to 0, which is the second equation given. So what do you understand by this? What do you understand by this? If it is fx, the second equation is got by replacing x with minus 1 by x. Replacing x with minus 1 by x. That means x is nothing but the root, I say. X is nothing but the root. If you want to check whether a particular number is a root of it or not, then in place of x only we substitute. That means x is nothing but a root. Now here x is made as minus 1 by x to get this equation. Because the power is 3, if I take the roots as alpha, beta, gamma for fx, if the roots are alpha, beta, gamma for fx, let me say this as some g of x. You tell me, what should be the roots of g of x? Because x is replaced with minus 1 by x. Here, alpha, beta, gamma are the roots of fx. Then, g of x roots must be what? Minus 1 by alpha, minus 1 by beta, minus 1 by gamma for g of x. Understand that? These are given to be in which progression? These are given to be in HP. What is HP? Harmonic progression. And if you find out the reciprocals of HP, reciprocal of HP, even though negative term is there, reciprocal of HP is nothing but AP. You all know that, the relation between AP and HP. Reciprocal of AP is HP. Reciprocal of HP is AP. That's what it is. Very simple. What should be your observation? What are the equations given? X is replaced with minus 1 by x, and hence alpha is to be replaced with minus 1 by alpha, beta is to be replaced with minus 1 by beta, gamma is to be replaced with minus 1 by gamma. These are in HP and their reciprocals will be in AP. Simple problem. So that should be your observation in the two given equation of that problem. Okay, let's go through the next one. This is also an important model. Like what? If alpha, beta are the roots of x cube plus qx plus r equal to 0, if alpha, beta are the roots of x cube plus qx plus r equal to 0, then the equation whose roots are beta, gamma plus 1 upon alpha in the cyclic order they are given. in the cyclic order, they are given beta gamma plus 1 upon alpha, comma gamma alpha plus 1 upon beta, comma alpha beta plus 1 upon gamma. Yes, its equation is needed. Just I want to remind you that method, because we have already discussed this, and in this one how to proceed, I'll tell you how to proceed. So what is required there, what is given there, what is required there? What is given? Given one is some fx is equal to x cube plus qx plus r. This is given, and its roots are given to be alpha, beta, gamma. Gamma is missing there. Alpha, beta, gamma are roots. So equation given, roots given. So what is required there? We need such an equation whose roots are beta gamma plus 1 upon alpha, comma gamma alpha plus 1 upon beta, comma alpha beta plus 1 upon gamma. These are the three roots. These are the three roots. You have to find out the equation whose roots are these. Anyway, these roots are consisting of alpha, beta, gamma only. These roots are consisting of alpha, beta, gamma only. So we will make use of that. So for that purpose, what we are doing here, beta, gamma plus 1 upon alpha, we take it as y. Now take LCM. Alpha, beta, gamma plus 1 upon alpha is equal to y. Alpha, beta, gamma is nothing but the product of the roots. Product of the roots. What is product of the roots there? Minus r upon 1. So minus r plus 1 upon alpha is equal to y. So what should be alpha in this case? Then you must get doubt. So why should we write alpha only? Because alpha is a root of this. It satisfies this equation. But I have taken this as y, then what I'm doing, I'm expressing alpha in terms of y. I'm expressing alpha in terms of y. And if alpha is expressed in terms of y, what should it be? 1 minus r upon y. But this alpha is root of this equation. And hence, what is to be done? This is to be substituted in that one to get the fresh equation. What is that fresh equation? That fresh equation will be containing these as roots. How is it? 1 minus r upon y whole cube plus q into 1 minus r upon y plus r must be equal to 0. You have to simplify this and you will get the equation in terms of y only. Y can be replaced with x. So final equation, you will get it as the second one, rx cube. Rx cube means this is y cube, this is y, this is r. So ry cube, ry cube, LCM, taking LCM, ry cube. That ry cube is given as rx cube. Y can be replaced with x, not a problem. So on simplifying this, we'll get the required equation. Okay. So what we did, alpha, beta, gamma are the roots of this. And we need such an equation whose roots are this. So, but of course, these roots are containing alpha, beta, gamma only. So with the use of alpha, beta, gamma and the relation between the coefficients and alpha, beta, gamma, we have taken this as y and taken LCM. Alpha, beta, gamma replaced with the product of the roots, and alpha is expressed to finally in terms of y. In terms of y. What is r? It is given by him. It is given in the question itself. So I replace the alpha in this equation. I'll simplify this to get the answer. So that should be the second option. Okay, let's go to the next question. And it is also a similar question, please understand that. If alpha, beta, gamma are the roots of x cube plus 3px plus q equals 0, then the equation whose roots are? It is also containing alpha, beta, gamma. So we have taken beta, gamma plus 1 by alpha as y. In this case, what you do? Alpha plus 1 upon divided by alpha plus 1 upon beta plus gamma minus alpha as y. Minus alpha as y. Then use the relations. Of course, this is not the equation.
This is not the equation. What is the equation by x cube plus 3px plus q equal to 0? Its roots are alpha, beta, gamma. And alpha plus 1 upon beta plus gamma minus alpha, etc., are the roots of the required equation. Then in such a case, we make use of this in this way. We take it as y. And then we'll convert in this way. Alpha plus beta plus gamma minus 2 alpha, right? Then you must think in this way. So how do we get this idea? Because beta plus gamma is there. If I add alpha, it becomes sum of the roots. Sum of the roots is very much known to us here. In this case, of course, x square coefficient is not there. X square coefficient is not there. So that becomes 0 minus 2 alpha is equal to y. So what should it be? It is alpha plus 1 is equal to minus 2 alpha y. So we need alpha in terms of y. So take alpha common, and it will be, if you take this side, 1 upon 2y minus 1. This is alpha. But what is alpha? It is the root of this. So what we do? We simply substitute that. We replace x with this one, and thereby you will get the required equation. The required equation will be, is given in terms of y only. This is a procedure to be followed. We will discuss more and more problems on this model. So you practice it. Next one. The same model. If alpha, beta, gamma are the roots of the equation, then the equation whose roots are alpha minus 1 by beta, gamma. That means here you will take alpha minus 1 by beta, gamma as y, and you will follow the same procedure. Practice such type of problems on your own, so that you'll be building up the confidence to solve the problems. Okay, let's go to the next question. And this is, you have to do this one using the derivative concept. So a1 square upon x minus a1 plus a2 square upon x minus a2 plus 1 plus ak square upon x minus ak is equal to m. And a i, capital A i, m or rational, then the equation has negative roots, positive roots, no real roots, no imaginary roots. Like that, you have to do that and make use of the concept of the derivative, and you can do that and try that on your own. Please note down that problem and try that on your own. Next one will be, if the roots of ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d equals 0 or in AP. If the roots of ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d equals 0 or in AP, then the roots of a of x plus k whole cube plus b of x plus k whole square plus c of x plus k plus d equals 0 or in what? Simple logic here. Remember, if fx equal to 0 is a polynomial equation, and if the root is, let me say, root is alpha, let me say. If you want the equation whose root will be, alpha plus k. I'll take a quadratic polynomial so that you'll better understand it. The quadratic polynomial roots are alpha gamma beta. An equation whose roots are alpha plus k gamma beta plus k. If k is added to roots, then to get the equation, you have to subtract k from x. For roots, k is added, then you have to subtract k from x. Understand that. So if the roots are subtracted, understand this please carefully. If k is subtracted, then it must be added in x. If k is multiplied, then in the equation it should be divided. If k is divided, if k is dividing the roots, then it must multiply in the equation. That's what it is. These are the four properties. Whatever the change that takes place in the roots, you must take the reverse process of it. For addition, subtract from x. For subtraction, add to x. For multiplication, divide x. For division, multiply x. Just reverse process. So if you see that equation now carefully, in place of x, you have x plus k. Do you understand what I'm saying? The equation given is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d equal to 0, or in AP. That is a standard cubic polynomial given. Ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d equal to 0. It is given as fx. Then if you write f of x plus k, what should it be? A of x plus k whole cube plus b of x plus k whole square plus c of x plus k plus d equal to 0.
What do you understand here?
If its roots are alpha, beta, gamma, and you are adding k to x, then this equation roots will be, the roots of this equation will be subtracting the roots. That is alpha minus k, beta minus k, gamma minus k.
Understand that? What I said?
X is replaced with
x plus k. You're adding k to x, then in the roots you must subtract k. You can check it out. It's very simple. You can check it out. If you are not understanding, you check it out by taking a simple equation. Like I'll explain it like this.
If you take 2, 3 as a roots, then the equation will be x squared minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0.
You need such an equation whose roots are 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1. Then what I'm saying, 1 is added to the roots, then 1 should be subtracted in the roots.
X minus 1 whole square minus 5 into x minus 1 plus 6 is equal to 0. Then what should it be? X square minus 2x minus 5x minus 7x plus 1 plus 6 plus 7 plus 7 plus 5 plus 12 equal to 0.
See the roots of it. 4 into 3, 12. 4, 3 are the roots here.
So this fx is becoming here f of x minus 1. Why? It is 1 is added to roots.
That is why 1 is subtracted in x. 1 is subtracted to the roots. 1 will be added here. If 2 is divided with k, 3 is divided with k, then x should be multiplied with k. If k is multiplying roots, then x should be divided with k. That's what. Simple example. You can understand. You take your practical examples whenever you want to learn any concept with more clarity. Then whenever you are learning a concept and you're not in a position to understand, then take some numerical examples and verify it. Then you'll feel that ease in solving the problems.
So it is given that these are in AP. When a constant term is added or subtracted, or multiplied or divided with the AP terms, then it remains AP only. That's what it is.
It again remains as AP only, because alpha, beta, gamma are given to be in AP, and alpha minus k, beta minus k, gamma minus k are also in AP. So the option there is AP. Go to that. Next problem. This is a similar question. What I discussed, alpha, beta, gamma are the roots of x cube plus bx square plus qx plus r equals to, then form an equation whose roots are alpha into beta plus gamma plus beta into gamma plus alpha plus gamma into alpha plus beta. Take first root as y and convert either alpha or beta or gamma in terms of y and replace that in the given equation. Thereby, you will get the answer. That's an important model. Next one. The roots of x cube minus 6x square plus 7x plus 2 equals 0. One root being 2 plus root 5. The other, or one is 2 plus root 5. Other one will be 2 minus root 5. So see the options there. 2 comma 2 plus or minus root 5. 2 plus or minus root 5 is not there. that should be given as 2 plus 1 minus root 5. Another one will be 2 minus root 7, something like that. So, no, it is a cubic equation.
Let's do that. X cube minus 6x square plus 7x plus 2 equal to 0. What is one of the roots given? 2 plus root 5. You'll understand now, clearly.
I'll form
the equation
whose roots will be 2 plus root 5, 2 minus root 5. Then why? Why should we take minus here? The irrational roots always occur in conjugate pairs. If 2 plus root 5 is a root, definitely 2 minus root 5 will also be a root if the coefficients are rational. If the coefficients are rational. Clearly, coefficients are rational. 2 plus root 5 is a root, then 2 minus root 5 will be definitely a root. So, in such a case, what is sum of the roots here? 4.
Product of the roots here. 4 minus 5 minus 1 equal to 0. So, what do you understand by this? You understand that this is one of the factors for this one.
This is one of the factors for this one.
Then what should be the other one?
We are interested in that one. One root being 2 plus root 5, what should be the other root?
So, what we're doing now, you just divide this. X cube minus 6x square plus 7x plus 2. This I'm taking you to
the elementary method, that is the direct division. But you can follow the synthetic division. That will be very comfortable to you. Synthetic division.
So, I'll multiply x with this one. X cube minus 4x square minus x. Cancel. Minus 2x square plus 8x plus 2. And now minus 2. Minus 2x square, and it is plus 8x plus 2. That's what I was saying. All the terms will be getting cancelled. You must get 0.
If 0 is a remainder, another root will be x minus 2.
So, this equation now can be written as x square minus 4x minus 1 into x minus 2.
So, what should be the roots here? One is 2 plus root 5, one is 2 minus root 5, another one is 2. So, you have 2 there. In the second option, in the first, third, fourth options you don't have. So it is 2, comma, 2 plus root 5. That is wrong. That should be 2 minus root 5. That is wrong. So second option is the correct answer. What are the roots? One is 2, another one will be 2 plus root 5, another one 2 plus root 5, another one will be 2 minus root 5. There's a printing error there. So the roots are 2, 2 plus root 5, 2 minus root 5. Okay. Next one. If 2, 3 are the roots of the equation 2x cube plus px square minus 13x plus q equal to 0, then p comma q. The roots are very much given there. 1 is 2 and 1 is 3. If you substitute 2 in the equation, it must be satisfied. It must be satisfying the equation because it's a root. Then thereby you'll get one equation in terms of p and q. If you substitute 3 in the equation, then you will get another equation in terms of p and q. So, what are the values we need? We need the values of p and q. We need the values of p and q. So how many equations do you have? Two equations you have. By solving those two equations, you'll get the values of p and q. Two roots given, substitute in the equation, get two equations in terms of p and q, and solve those two equations to get the values of p and q. It's a very simple problem. Okay, go to the next one. If two roots are 1 comma 7, then the roots are simple. You verify the options. Two roots are given 1, 7, and the other roots, you verify the options. Otherwise, what you have to do? You have to follow the same procedure. Follow the same procedure to get another factor. But it is fourth degree polynomial, and hence, the other equation you will get will be of power 2 only. Will be of power 2 only. So, by solving them, you will get the roots. And if you do the procedure, do like this, if you want to confirm the answer, you can simply substitute the options in the question and you can verify the option because it's a single correct answer question. And next one, if one of the roots of x power 4 minus 5x square plus 10x square minus 20x plus 24 equal to 0 is purely imaginary, then the roots are. It is given that it is one is purely imaginary. One is purely imaginary means if it is something like 2 plus 5y.
Otherwise, let me take the general form. Let me take the general form. If one is alpha plus I beta, Another one will be definitely alpha minus I beta.
It is given. The roots are purely imaginary. So verify the options there. You have only one option is containing imaginary roots, plus or minus 2i. And you, this is a simple question. You can verify the options. Let's go to the next one. If two roots are equal, then the roots are. This is when the roots are asked. Simply take the roots and substitute in the equation to verify. Next one is the roots are of. Next question. The roots of x cube minus 3x square plus 4 equals 0 when there is a multiple root. You understand this, please, carefully. Multiple roots concept. Concept of multiple roots. I will explain through an example. I'm forming an equation 1, 1, 2. Whose roots are 1, 1, 2? I'm forming an equation whose roots are 1, 1, 2. So what is it? X cube minus sum of the roots into x square plus product of the roots by taking 2 at 1 into 1, 1 plus 2. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 2, 5x minus product of the roots equal to 0. That's what the equation I have formed by taking this. Let it be some fx. Let me verify. 1 plus 5, 6 minus 6 gets cancelled. 8. 8 plus 10, 18. 18 minus 18, 0. So these are the roots here. So let's forget about this now, because we have formed this equation on our own. You remember? What are the roots taken? 1, 1, 2. That means 1, 1 means repeated roots are there. Repeated roots. What are the repeated roots? 1 is the repeated root. The 1 comes for 2 times. It may come for 3 times also. Then it will be x minus 1 whole cube. It will be x minus 1 whole cube. So what? How multiple roots conceptual problems are to be solved? That's what I'm explaining now. If I take f dash x, it is 3x squared minus 8x plus 5. Now I will equate it to 0. What are the factors here? This is 3x squared minus 3x, take 3x common into x minus 1 into minus 5 is equal to 0. So what are you getting here? X equal to 3, 5 by 3, or x equal to 1. Where from we have got it? By equating this to 0. Therefore, f dash 1 equal to 0. Understand that. Because it is taken from this only. Or of course, f dash 5 by 3 will also be 0. F dash 5 by 3 also be 0 because these two are the roots. Now what I'm doing to have the multiple roots, this root must satisfy fx also. Let us check it out. What should be f of 1? 1 minus 4 plus 5 minus 2 equal to 0. That means if there is a multiple root, then that multiple root satisfies fx and f dash x. Because it is a cubic, if it satisfies fx and f dash x, there will be two equal roots. If it is something like power 4, let me say, for example, then the roots, let me say, 1, 1, 2. How many multiple roots are there? 3 multiple roots are there. In that case, of course, this is not the equation representing these roots. Then in that case, what must happen? F of 1 must be 0. F dash 1 must be 0. F double dash 1 must also be 0. Then F triple dash 1 is not equal to 0. Then in this case, you will have 3 equal roots. This is the concept of multiple roots. Okay. Now if you go through that question now, x cube minus 3x square plus 4 equal to 0. Let us solve it now. I hope you all understand the concept of multiple roots. What is the equation given? X cube minus 3x square plus 4 equal to 0. Then it is fx. What should be f dash x? 3x square minus 6x. And let f dash x equal to 0 because I'm interested in finding the roots of f dash x. Roots of f dash x is equal to 3 into x square minus 2.
3 into 3x into x minus 2. It is equal to 0 implies x is equal to 0 or x is equal to 2. If you substitute 0 here, this is 4, not 0. If you substitute 0 here, it is 4, not 0. Then if you substitute 2 here, check it out. If you substitute 2 here, it is 2 cube 8 minus, let me write that. F of 0 is equal to 4, not equal to 0. Let me write f of 2, 2 cube 8 minus 3 into 4, 12 plus 4 is equal to 0. That means, what is the conclusion here? F of 2 equal to 0 and f dash 2, of course, 0. Because it is got from this only. So, it is satisfied by both first derivative, x equal to 2 is satisfying the first derivative as well the given function. So, what should be the common root in this case now? Common root is 2. So, what should it be? 2. And the other root you want, you can form an equation from this one and you can divide that with this one. Then you will get the other root. And if you see the options there, it is 2, and the other one obviously will be minus 1. You can find it out. So, multiple root concept is to be solved through the derivative. So, if two roots are equal or multiple of 2, like two roots are equal like 2, then the condition is you must get f of 2, 0, f dash 2, 0. If there are three roots equal, like this, then you tell me what should it be, and f double dash 2 is also equal to 0. So, the number of roots are 3, up to second derivative is 0. Number of roots are 2, up to first derivative, it is 0. The number of roots are, multiple roots are r, then f of r minus 1 of x must be equal to 0. Here r is 3. 3 minus 1, 2. Second derivative. Like that, you can understand about the multiple roots concept in theory of equations. Okay. Now, let's go to the next one. This is also multiple roots. You have to apply the same concept for that one also. And next one also, the multiple roots, you can understand if the roots of x power 4 minus 6x cube plus 13x square minus 12x plus 4 equal to 0 or alpha, beta, then values of alpha, beta, or is also the concept of multiple roots. Because alpha is repeated twice and beta is also repeated twice. Otherwise, you can form equations by writing the relation between the roots and the coefficients. You can solve for alpha and beta, or you can simply verify the options. It's very simple. Okay, let's go to the next one. If there is a multiple root of order 3 of equation, then the other root is, you can solve those problems in a similar way. So, let's forward this to the matrices. Come on, forward that. Yes, matrices. It's very simple. You all know very well about the multiplication and multiplication of matrices, addition, subtraction, multiplication, all this, you know. So, you keep practicing matrices problems to save the time by writing the direct steps. That means you have to improve your mind calculation first in working out the problems. So, here, first question, if you see, if A is equal to ABCD and A square is equal to alpha, beta, gamma, then what is the relation here? A is equal to ABCD. And A square is given to be, and A square is given to be, A square is given to be what? Alpha, beta, beta, gamma. Alpha, beta, beta, gamma. That's what. So, then what do we need? What should be the value of alpha? You can see the options there. You are given relations between alpha, AB, beta, AB, like that. That means you have to compare this to by finding A square. While writing A square, imagination, imagination. Like what? A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. Don't write this, but try to calculate through the mind. Imagine this in the mind and then try to save the time through multiplication. A into A square plus BC. AB plus BD. AC plus CD. BC plus D square. So, this is very simple. Now, this is to be compared with this one. Two matrices are said to be equal. The concept of equality of two matrices. Two matrices are said to be equal if their order are equal, number one. Number two, corresponding elements are equal. What does it mean? Equality. Equality of two functions. Equality of real numbers. Equality of vectors. Equality of matrices. Equality of matrices is possible only when the order, it is 2 by 2. It is also 2 by 2. So now you can equate. The corresponding elements. Alpha is A square plus BC. Beta is AB plus BT. Beta is AC plus CD. Gamma is BC plus D square. So whatever is given there, you can check it out. Beta is given to be, what is alpha given? A square plus B square. What is we find out there? A square, alpha, beta, beta, gamma. AB, CD. AB, CD into AB, CD. A square. ABCD into ABCD, A square. So A square plus BC is correct only. ZB plus BD is correct only. Now, you compare this and eliminate. What you have to do here, alpha is equal to A square plus BC is given there. And beta is given to be from this one, AB plus BD. But from this one, beta is AC plus CD. From this one, gamma is BC plus D square. Make use of this and eliminate, and thereby you will get those relations. Okay? We will continue discussing matrices in the next session. We will be doing more and more problems on the matrices in the next session. Okay? Good night.